يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله والكتاب الذي أنزل من قبل ومن يكفر بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا إن الذين آمنوا ثم كفروا ثم آمنوا ثم كفروا ثم ازدادوا كفرا لم يكن الله ليغفر لهم ولا ليهديهم سبيلا صدق الله العظيم.
As soon as I think about talking أحاديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم comes to my mind when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم describing the fitness befalling the ummah said والذي نفسي بيده لألفينهم فتنة تدع الحليم فيهم حيرانا. Allah say, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath and says, when my servants are going to start disobeying me, I would throw some fitnas on them that will confuse the wisest person and he won't know what to do with it and how to deal with it. The topic of fitnas is very long, and ahadith talk in detail about it. The gist of the ahadith about how it was said is very clear, and we don't have to read too many ahadith to know what would stand the fitna. And simply, the reason for that as described in the ahadith, the ummah not willing to follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's something, when we talk about it, it looks like, no, we are not the cause. It's other people. And even after hearing the hadith, each person thinks it's not us and it's not me. I gave an example once before that sometime in the jungles you see a rock and there is water dripping in it, on it, and there is a hole in that rock. What made that hole in that rock? The first drop or the last drop? Which of these drops made that hole in that rock? It's not the first one. It's not the last one. It's the combination of all of these drops. Each and every drop that was falling on that rock did something to it, played its role. That drop never thought that he would be able to break and make a hole in that rock. But at the end, regardless of how many years it took, finally we see a hole in the rock. If these drops, that might be millions of them, were alive and had the power of speech, and you talk to them and you ask them, which of you made this hole? And all of them will tell you that we are so weak that I can't do this. One drop on a rock, what can it do? It can do nothing. And second drop says, you know, I can do nothing. I was only one of these drops and I just fell on the rock, and what can I do to the rock? But in reality, all of these drops are the one who did it. If it is good, something good, to have a hole over there, they all will get the award for it, and if it is something bad, then they all get the punishment for it. And they are all responsible for it. Now, who made the hole? Who created the fitna? I say it wasn't me. And you say it wasn't you. And every person in the ummah says it wasn't us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises us that if you don't stand the fitna, I won't allow other people to come and do a fitna for you. If you want to start it, people won't be able to start it on you. This is a promise by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the ones that are making that hole in the rock, we are one of those drops. And each and every person in the ummah is responsible for it. With our deeds, with what we have been doing with our deen, with how we follow this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we use the word ummah, what is an ummah? All of us together is an ummah. So each and every individual counts when we count the ummah. And whatever individuals do, finally it will be considered the act of the ummah. Because we together form an ummah. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got up during the night time, he looked around and he said, Subhanallah, ماذا أنزل الليلة من الفتن? Look at the fitness that came down today. مَنْ يُوْقِذُ صَوَاحِبَ الْحَجُرَاتِ Who's going to wake up all of these women that are sleeping? The reason Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying this to inform us that at least a protection for yourself from these fitnas is wake up at that time. Do something at that time that might protect you against the fitnas that are before you. The things that we see around us, if we look at the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we would realize that this is not the end, this is the beginning. And there is a lot more to come. To that extent, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there won't be any house left in the world where the fitna won't enter. It will enter each and every home. The most important thing for us now to think about is how to protect ourselves, our deen, our iman. And of course, simply protection means that protecting the most valuable thing so that when we face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, at least we have that thing to present, and that is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because one of the things that will happen during these fitnas, as mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is يصبح الرجل فيها مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا. A person will be a mu'min in the morning, kafir in the evening. A person leaves his home ويمسي كافرا ويمسي مؤمنا ويصبح كافرا. Leaves home in the evening. He was mu'min. Next morning when he left home, when he came back or when he was seen, he was a kafir. He had left his room. He had objections about the deen. He has objections about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has uttered words that are against the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has said things that are against the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these things just got him out of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This person himself thinks that he is still a believer. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, in our record, in Allah's record, this person is not in the list of believers. In fact, he is in the list of disbelievers. Simple words, objections, they can just get the person out of it. With all of this that we see, a very important question comes to mind, and that is, what will happen to our children's iman? What are we going to do about their faith? How would they know that what are Allah's promises and that His promises are true? Are they connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this deen? Do they have at least this connection to the deen of Allah through the salah that can protect them from falling into kufr? Or even salah is not in their lives. They don't even perform that salah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, كل من الحديث بين المرء والكفر ترك الصلاة. The only thing that holds the person into iman is salah. As soon as the person starts missing the salah, he falls into kufr. Do they know the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can that mean when they're discouraged, have no answers to their questions? Can it maybe that no one is able to convince them at that time? At least they are connected to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a way that say, okay, let me just recite some Quran and get satisfaction of mine. Even if I don't understand it, when I read the book of Allah, alhamdulillah, I get satisfied.